In this class, we will start writing our CSS code. As you can see, I have a background color on my web page. I also have a background color across the top, which is my header element. Inside my header element, I have an H1 element with some text. Notice that that text has a color. Notice that that text also has a shadow, which has a color. So we will learn how we apply colors and background colors using some element selectors. In order to write CSS, you need to be aware of the structure of your document because the CSS will be applied to particular parts of your document. So here we see our header section, which contains our H1 element, and we have a main section. Inside that main section, we have a section element, which contains several unordered lists and several H2 elements, in addition to my paragraph and image tag. We will begin to learn about using an embedded style sheet. An embedded style sheet is created using the style element. This is an HTML element inside which we place our CSS styles. The style tag is placed in the head section, and it should be placed after our meta tag and our title tag. I would like to point out the syntax of CSS comments. Notice how they are slash asterisk, your text, asterisk slash. Notice the difference between a CSS comment and an HTML comment. The HTML comments belong in the document. The CSS comments belong inside the style element. In CSS, we have an asterisk selector, which stands for everything. So if you wanted to apply a style to every element, you would use the asterisk selector. When you begin writing your CSS code, you always want to define what are called the default or global styles for your web page. What is my background color going to be? What is my font family going to be? What is the default size of the font? And possibly other things such as line height. These styles are applied to the body selector. So I have rules or declarations. As we see here, I have four rules or declarations. They are each separated with a semicolon. And the syntax is property colon value. So we have property colon value semicolon, property colon value semicolon, etc. The spacing that you see is my personal choice. You can use whatever works best for you as long as you use it consistently. You can put spaces on each side of the semicolon. You can put no spaces on the semicolon. You can put no spaces after the commas. You can run your code across the screen. However, this is a very nice, easy to read, and professional layout, and you will find that most developers adhere to this format. You should all start out deciding on what font you're going to use, and here I have Arial because it is a very popular font. You will notice that web developers always initialize the font size to 100%. This puts all of your other relative units proportional to this starting point. If I wanted to apply a background color to the entire page, I could do so using the background color property. If I wanted to apply a line height to my elements, I could do so using the line height property. There are a lot of different properties in CSS, and you can find more information about them, not only in your text, but also on the internet. In CSS, if a property has more than one word, it is hyphenated. Although it is not case sensitive, you will find that developers always use lowercase. Next, you see I have an H1 element being used as a select. So that is my H1 in my header. And I can adjust the font size and the color. Notice I am using the RGB format. The text shadow property takes a minimum of three values. The first value is the horizontal offset. The second value is the vertical offset. The next value, which is optional, is the blur, and then the color. The text align property is how we center text inside an HTML element. So if I wanted my text to be centered, this is the property that I would use. So as you can see in my webpage, because I have applied the background color to the body, my entire page has a background color. And you can see my styles being applied to my H1 element. Now I also have a background color being applied to my header element. Notice my H1 is inside the header, and here I am using a color name. So you can see that my entire header is navy. Notice that it extends the entire width of my web page. By default, all block level elements extend 100% the width of their parent container. In this case, the parent container is the body. Inside my H1 element, I have an inline style. An inline style is coded using the style attribute. That is an HTML attribute. However, the values are CSS. So here we have property colon value semicolon, property colon value semicolon. And I am using the text indent property and the letter spacing property. I am using pixel units of measure to set those values. So here we can see that we have a little bit more spacing than normal. So in this class, we are looking at the color property and the background color property. We are also looking at the various properties that can be used to configure text, and we are applying them using an element selector inside our embedded style sheet in the head section, or by using the HTML style attribute, which allows us to create an inline style.